Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In this video, I'll continue talking about equality in Islam, but this time from stories happened at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and afterwards with his companion. In the previous video, we mentioned ayat that emphasized the importance of equality of all mankind and how it is not about the color or race. But in this video, we will focus on how did the Sahaba and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did live that practically in their day-to-day lives. So let's do that among these beautiful stories. At the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lived all his life promoting equality, and he never looked at his companion from who is from which tribe. That never happened in the seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, the second action that he did after the first one was building the mosque, the second action that he did was al-mu'akha. He created brotherhood between the people who immigrated with him and the people who lived in Medina, the people from Medina, al-Ansar. And that's more of like mentoring help program that the people who live there and they are well established in Medina, from Medina, to help one-on-one to help their brothers who came from Mecca. So it did not matter the different origin or the difference in the economical status, they become more of like brothers. And that program kept going on as people converted and came from Mecca to Medina, as people needed more help. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept doing that. And there is many famous stories about this mu'akha or brotherhood, but there is one less famous that happened after the second year of Hijra, when Salman al-Farisi is a famous Sahabi, famous because he's from different origin. He's Persian. His name is Farisi. So Salman came and converted to Islam. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam made him brother with Abu Darda. Abu Darda is a more famous Sahabi. And I might come to this story later because this has more details how Salman corrected Abu Darda. But they are from different origin, different places, and how they become totally brothers, and they are like true brothers to each other. That is what happened at the time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The most famous story how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at Bilal. Bilal was a slave, and his slave master Abu Jahl, Umayy ibn Khalaf, is the most famous or among the most famous Quraysh non-Muslims, and he tortured him till Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was able to buy Bilal, because Bilal was a slave. And the famous story that Abu Jahl gave up on Bilal, and he said that I would have given Bilal to you for much cheaper, for one dinar. And Abu Bakr did not hesitate or thought that he lost. He said, and I would have paid you much more, Abu Jahl. That's just to promote the value of Bilal. They did not care about he was a slave, he was a Habashi, he was a black, he was not does not belong to that community. That never was on the radar of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, because he understood the true meaning of Islam. And then Bilal become among the top Sahaba immediately. He was the Muaddin, that the one that says the Adhan, the one that stand up on the Kaaba. Not everybody has that honor and privilege. He was the one that does that. And Bilal has a history full of incidents that we can promote the equality. But I want to fast forward till after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam died and Abu Bakr become the Khalifa. So Bilal wanted to emigrate to Sham. He wanted to leave. I think he could not live in Medina after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. But Abu Bakr told him, I want you to stay, because I would like to hear the Adhan from you. And what did Bilal answer the Khalifa? The Khalifa is like the president, the king, if you will. And he knew that Abu Bakr is the one who freed him. He bought him from Abu Jahl and made him free. So what did Bilal answer Abu Bakr? Bilal said, if you freed me to become free, then I want to leave. If you freed me to become your slave, then I would stay. Then Abu Bakr said, no, I freed you up for Allah and you are free. I'm just begging you to stay. And then Bilal bin Rabah decided to leave and he left to Sham. This is the life of the Sahaba, the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no place for hate based on racism, based on color, based on white and black, based on brown and yellow or any other color. This is the life of Prophet and his companion. After Abu Bakr, Umar bin al-Khattab became the Khalifa. And Umar bin al-Khattab, at that time, Egypt had become Muslim territory. And Umar bin al-Khattab hired Amr bin al-Aas as the Wali of Egypt. And Amr bin al-Aas had his son racing in a horse race with a Coptic Christian person in Egypt. And that Coptic person beat the son of the Wali, the son of the ruler of Egypt, the son of Amr ibn al-As. And the son of Amr ibn al-As did not like it. He's no one to me. And then what did he do? He slapped him. That person traveled from Egypt to Medina and complained to Umar ibn al-Khattab about the action of the son of Amr ibn al-As. So what did Umar ibn al-Khattab do? Umar ibn al-Khattab is famous for his justice. He called Amr ibn al-As to come immediately from Egypt, him and his son. And they traveled to Medina. Traveling at that time, you can imagine, it's a hardship. And they traveled to Medina. And when they went there, they met with Umar ibn al-Khattab. Umar ibn al-Khattab said that, what did you do to this person? He said that, I slapped him. And Umar ibn al-Khattab asked that person to slap the son of Amr ibn al-As and then to slap Amr ibn al-As. And that person said, oh Umar, it's like this person slapped me. His father didn't do anything. He was not there even. But Umar ibn al-Khattab said that he slapped you with the power of his father. He thought that he's better than you because of who his father is. So he wanted to make those Walis humble, and they don't think for a second that they are better than the average person because they are either Arabs or even because they're Muslims or because his father is so and so or because his father is a Sahabi. So it was a big lesson that Umar ibn al-Khattab gave to this Wali Amr ibn al-As and his son. And Umar ibn al-Khattab said to Amr ibn al-As something that become a motto or a quote that people use, متى استعبدتم الناس وقد ولدتهم أمهاتهم أحرارا. When did you make people a slave and they were born free? This is what Umar ibn al-Khattab said, and this is what Islam promotes, of equality of all people regardless of their ethnicity or of their color or of anything else. In this short video, we heard a couple of stories about the Sahaba and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in the next video, I'm going to focus on stories happened at the time of Ali bin Abi Talib, or Ali bin Abi Talib was part of it, and talking about the same topic, about equality between all mankind. If you like this video, share it with your contacts, and I will see you next time, inshallah.